It was hard to believe that one day you could be in your office in Los Angeles and the next standing on a ridge on the Alaskan Peninsula watching the sun come up. I think that every bull hunter dreams of going to Alaska. I know I did for a long, long time. I found that Alaska was everything I had hoped it would be. It's a spectacular country. The magnificent scenery and the animals on the rolling tundra flats were very exciting to see. It was really a bow hunter's paradise, and for me it was the beginning of a fabulous adventure.
Arriving in King Salmon, Alaska, Jim Dougherty was met by one of Alaska's best guides, Ed King. Ed is thoroughly familiar with the Alaskan Peninsula and promised Jim some good, solid hunting. The next morning, they took off in Ed's Super Cub and flew another 150 miles west on the Alaskan Peninsula to the Mishuk River. Along the way, Jim's camera had a field day with the moose, other animals they saw, and of course, the interesting scenery. The cabin on an island in the Mishuk River had been flown in by Ed King, board by board, piece by piece. It isn't fancy, but is sound, dry, and warm. Landings are a little hairy, but Jim's confidence in Ed's ability was well-founded. Good night's sleep, breakfast, and the excitement of the first day's hunt did not allow the windy, gloomy morning to dampen Jim's enthusiasm. Their plan was to fly up to the Cinder River flats in the search for caribou. Caribou were there all right, but Jim learned one thing right off. The flat country made it quite difficult to get closer than several hundred yards. They decided it would be best to get ahead of one of the migrating herds and try to head them off. Late afternoon and many tiring, unsuccessful stalks later, Jim and Ed were glassing four different herds when several good bull caribou came along. They moved out, planning on a 500-yard stalk to try and catch them when they came up on the cinder flats. By the time they got to the spot they wanted, the caribou were halfway across the flats and about 65 yards out. It was a long shot, but the only one Jim was going to get. The arrow caught the bull a little far back. The caribou spooked at the shot and made a big circle around Jim and Ed, heading back into the tag alders. Following the blood trail, Jim picked them up again in the heavy cover, and without having to take another shot, found the bull down and out.
Well, he was my first caribou, and I was very proud of him. He wasn't a record class animal, but I was very pleased. He was a dandy little bull, made a nice trophy. We could certainly use the meat in camp and take the rest of it to the Indian village down the river. Shotgun and went down the mouth of the river. I'm a confirmed waterfowl nut, I guess. A chance for me to get an emperor goose or two to add to my collection of mounted birds was something that I really wanted to do. The goose shooting was fabulous. Geese were real fine eating bird. They certainly did a lot to change the menu in camp.
The next day, the weather broke, and Jim returned to the cinder flats. You're allowed three caribou in Alaska, but Jim felt he only needed one more chance to get the one he came for. They spotted two bulls, 200 to 300 yards out, and made a long circle approach. The bull spotted Jim about 75 yards out. The only thing he could do was duck down and run in for a quick shot at about 30 yards.
It's hard to believe that you could go that far, work that hard, and then miss a caribou at 30 yards. Well, I missed him beautifully. I was pretty upset with myself, but on the other hand, that's part of the game. Can't win them all.
About 4 hours later, they were in a pretty good position to head off a herd, and Jim again tried a running approach. About a 50-yard downhill shot. Jim picked out the largest bull. And the arrow caught him in the last rib, angling forward. He started stumbling, and Jim's pulse rate doubled as he watched him. Then, all of a sudden, the bull stumbled sideways and fell. He was down in the middle of a huge meadow. The herd stopped and looked back at him, then moved off as Jim approached.
I've always felt that a mature bull caribou is one of the most magnificent animals in the world. And this was the caribou that I had come to Alaska for. It was a real fine animal, and I was very pleased. It turned out that later we had an official score of 371.5, which put him in the record book. It was kind of the first hurdle in my quest for a successful trip.